In a talk you gave, you were reflecting on having incorporated the arts into the movement and that you would have liked to have incorporated the sciences. What would it look like to incorporate sciences into the Triratna Buddhist community, and is it still possible?
Well, you will have noticed that among all the books that I've mentioned, there wasn't a single word of science. But I thought that's a very big omission. But yes, perhaps I did, yes, many, many years ago, I did actually read The Origin of Species. But I can't remember any other scientific work which I've read. But nonetheless, I do think that it is important for our movement in a general way to take account of the scientific way of thinking and also scientific discoveries which may illustrate some of the teachings of the Buddha. I've always, from the very beginning, been very averse to seeing science as in any way proving the truth of Buddhism. But I have also said that the scientific attitude, that is to say, of openness and readiness to face the truth, even when it is a new truth, is very compatible with the Buddhist attitude of openness toward life and towards new thought. We do have, I know, people in the order, people in the movement who are trained for scientists, and I certainly would like to see them making their distinctive contribution to our development movement.